from the American Museum of Natural History in New York, and here to talk a bit about an MVP, or minimum viable product. This is a concept that's been around for some time in entrepreneurial and startup circles, but it might be helpful to sort of think about it first in contrast to what it is not, maybe a process you're familiar with, where you have an idea for a product, you know, whether it's an app or a website or whatever. You get all your stakeholders in your room, you have a bunch of meetings, you brainstorm all the awesome features that you want to deliver, you go out and you build it, and then you launch it, and then you move on to the next thing. In contrast to that, an MVP, or a minimum viable product, is launching that earliest possible version of your product instead, with just prototypes of the features that you think your visitors will want, and then gathering information from how your visitors are responding to what you've just released, and then using that information to build the next version, and the next version, and the next version of your product. So the idea of an MVP goes hand in hand with this concept of continuous improvement. Continuous improvement is really just incremental changes, incremental improvements to your product over the life cycle of that product. So it's really a waypoint in a much longer process. And when you think about an MVP approach and continuous improvement, you really have to consider that larger context in which your product is supposed to operate or how you intend it to operate. And think about it as just one sort of point or one sort of milestone in a much longer process. So this type of an approach in product development is really demanding. It demands sustained attention, it demands continuous refinement, continuous attention to the analytics that you're gathering, and I don't know about your organizational culture, but that can sometimes be a tall order. I know it's definitely been difficult for us to reorient our thinking at the museum. So a real-world example of this is a redesign of our website at amnh.org. We're tackling this in two major phases, and the first phase is what we're calling kind of a repaint of the site. We're not touching the navigation or the architecture, but instead we're bringing new fonts, new layouts, colors, things of that nature. And then once we get that baseline redesign up on the site, we're going to continue our A/B testing program that we've already started and try to, you know, bring continuous improvements, tweaks, small changes to the website in response to the information that we're gathering through analytics or qualitative user feedback. And the idea is that we'll continue this over the life of our website in its current or in its future redesign state and hopefully bring a better visitor experience to all of our digital visitors. So, sorry for this stock photo, but so the idea is really to elevate the thinking in how you really think about product development and the features that you want to build into your products. An MVP approach and continuous improvement really helps elevate the discussion, and for us, this definitely helped elevate the internal discussion away from feature-centric ideas, and instead, you know, what are those longer-term sort of umbrella goals of things like engagement and reach? And you kind of have to also remember that this is asking a lot of your stakeholders. Stakeholders have to get on board with the idea that you're effectively inviting your visitors and your digital users into the process of designing the next versions of your product. So that might be appealing or it might be frightening, you know, depending on your particular culture. I know for us, it's definitely helped streamline the thinking in how we invest in future development. Data is your friend. So after a post or after you've launched your MVP, you really have to have a way to measure, you know, how are we doing? We're looking here at some analytics, Google Analytics, gathered from our site that we're going to be using to help inform the next version of the redesigned website. So data, both qualitative and quantitative, is really key too. It's been helpful for us anyway in sort of creating guardrails for how you prioritize your roadmap. So, for example, we're going to have a number of features on our roadmap for our website going forward, that we want to make sure are aligned to data that we're actually gathering and not necessarily, you know, the whims of any particular group of stakeholders. We're also learning that in the previous version of our site, we invested a whole lot into features that were actually never even used. So we want to avoid that in the next version. So finally, adapting and iterating is really at the heart of the MVP and continuous improvement approach. MVP really isn't the goal in and of itself. It's really just a way to help orient internal dialogue and help orient your product development process around your visitors and around data. So it's a very iterative, it's a very active, it's a very adaptive approach, but it's one that invites your visitors into the product design process, which is never a bad thing. So finally, continuous improvement is key. Focus on your users and their goals, not necessarily features. Use relevant data, and finally, adapt and iterate. I would love to continue the discussion with anyone out there who's thinking about this type of thing. So please come find me. Thank you.